welcome, Star Wars fans all across the galaxy. This is Uneducated Star Wars Talk, brought to you by the Uneducated Network. I'm your host, Chris Lambert, and thanks for making me a part of your day. There have been a lot of news that dropped since the last time we talked. Well, not a lot of news, but some news that I like to talk about, some news that I can just ignore and stuff like that. But the biggest, one of the biggest news drops is that Episode 9 started filming August 1st. And that was great news to me because I'm looking forward to this. It's all Star Wars movies. And it's scheduled to drop around December next year. So that gives them basically a year and a half of filming, refilming what they need to refilm, editing what they need to edit and everything. That gives J.J. Abrams the time that he needs to make the movie we want, and the movie that can possibly bond us Star Wars fans together, because we've been very decisive over the last couple movies. So hopefully that's enough time to help them get it right, help Lucasfilm tinker the way they got to tinker and everything. But hopefully this is good news to me, because I just like the fact that the film started filming and everything, that they getting it underway, and it always makes it more real that another Star Wars movie is coming. And I've been really posing the question, do you think that it's too many movies in a row, that you want to go back to that one movie like every 2 or 3 years feeling that we had during the prequels, and, well, for me, the prequels, because that's when I was growing up. But if you're one of those older fans, do you prefer it that way, with that 3-year wait, like with the original trilogy and the prequels, like I said? Or do you like getting movies year after year and everything? Me, I'm a bit in the middle. It's a bit of a balance. I do miss that feeling leading up to movies, having to wait and stuff, like just being able to speculate, even though we do that now anyway, but being able to speculate for years about what the next movie is going to entail and everything. But also, as a fan of Star Wars, I love getting new content every year, along with also everything they're doing with the novels and everything, the shows. I love this slew of content that we get in movies, TVs, books, everything like that. So it's not a big problem to me, but I'm asking my fans, what do y'all think? Back to Episode 9, it also was announced that Lando will be a part of it. Billy Dee Williams himself is reprising this role as Lando, and that's even better. That's better news than them starting filming to me, because we all want Lando back, especially after seeing him in Solo, a Star Wars Story and everything. Even some of his roles in the books been good. He's only made like two after Episode 6 appearances, I believe. One in Empire's End, I believe so. It was Empire's End. I know it was around the time when Kylo was still a baby and Lando was picking out like a blaster or something for him. Spoilers if you haven't read that book, but I do believe it's Empire's End. And at that point, he was back on Bespin. We got older Lando in a more recent book, Last Shot, Han and Lando story. So, and then again, he was back on Bespin. So I want to see what he's up to. I know he's probably getting his money right, because Lando's always been about his money and doing that droid factory that he had plans to do. So we'll have to see. But like I said, it's just great news that he's back in Episode 9, that we get some more Lando on screen. And a bigger question is did they bring him back just to kill him? I hope not, because I'm liking Lando more than I ever did, learning more about him and everything. So we'll just have to see. I don't know if they just going to bring him back to kill him. I would hope not. Maybe he'll be one of the last surviving original rebellion leaders and everything. That would be a nice story, because right now it isn't too many. We don't know where Mon Mothma is. Not to my knowledge, I don't think. Like I said, I've just checked the books and everything. But we don't know where Mon Mothma is. Ackbar got taken out. And there's a lot of people we don't know exactly where they is. Exactly where they are right now. But like I said, Lando might could be one of the last living, and Leia's still around movie wise, so we'll have to see how her story ties up in Episode 9. But maybe Lando does survive and he be the last surviving leader of the original rebellion or something, and that would be a great mark for Lando, and I would love to see that. So hopefully they don't kill him off and he can be that that living legend of the rebellion that the rebellion probably should have. They deserve to have after setting the galaxy free and everything. But another big news drop was they announced at Comic-Con. They had a trailer and everything. Be tuned for my trailer breakdown of it. And I know I'm running crazy late. I had a lot of things going on, but I'm not going to bore y'all to death about life stories. We hear about our fantasy land in Star Wars. But during Comic-Con, they announced Clone Wars is coming back, and they dropped a great trailer. The trailer didn't entail too much. It was a lot of old dialogue with some a couple older scenes from the past Clone Wars. The shot that did get me was the shot with all of the capital ships in the background. It's just, it looked like it's going to be the Clone Wars was, and I really can't wait for that. I'm a big fan of the older Clone Wars series. Really wish they wouldn't just let it hang the way it did. And I'm glad, I hope Dave Filoni had a lot to do with it. I haven't looked it up yet, but I'm pretty sure Dave Filoni had a big hand in bringing the Clone Wars back, and even his hand on a lot of the storytelling and everything, and that should make it just as great as the original Clone Wars, not the original Clone Wars, but the last Clone Wars series was, and I can't wait to see them tie that up. They announced that that's going to be coming on Disney streaming service sometime in 2020, I believe, and that'll be great for that service would already have my subscription, but having the Clone Wars exclusively on there, that's pretty good. And I think they announced that it'll be like 12 episodes, but who knows? Maybe with the a big surge of an audience going to it, everybody watching it, maybe they'll extend it a little bit further, which I don't know if they can do, because maybe they'll start blending in Revenge of the Sith. But the galaxy is so big to me, and yeah, the Star Wars galaxy, that is, but the Star Wars galaxy is so big to me, and the Clone Wars was such a huge war that they can tell different stories from anywhere throughout the Clone Wars and everything. But I can't wait for the Clone Wars to come back. And the Anakin and Ahsoka talking at the end of the trailer was great. We get to see hopefully more of them, get to see what happened before they met when he was Vader, see if they actually did meet again and everything. Well, maybe that's just a big misdirect in the trailer. We'll have to see. But Clone Wars coming back on that Disney streaming service whenever that drops, and ooh, I'm super excited for that. And hopefully we get to see some characters come back from the original Clone Wars, since this is a continuation of it. Maybe we get to see Cad Bane, who was one of the better villains in there. I can't wait to see more Count Dooku, because I'm a bigger fan of Count Dooku from the Clone Wars, more so than I am in the movies, because he really got a little bit more developed in the Clone Wars, him and Sidious' relationship and everything. So hopefully we get to see more of that, more of some of the characters we love. Like I said, hopefully we get some more Ahsoka and everything. I don't really know how they're going to handle Ahsoka up in there, but she is one of the fan favorites right now for more stories wanted about her. So maybe they do, maybe this is the place to do that with the Clone Wars. So we'll have to see. Like I said, I'm super excited for it. The fan community went nuts from what I seen, and this was a big positive bringing back the Clone Wars. So Disney, good job. Can't wait to log into their streaming service and get a check of it. Also, the latest in the news drop, the Blu-ray release date for Solo: A Star Wars Story, one of the more decisive movies in the fan community right now, got announced on the 14th. It's going to be dropping digitally on all the digital platforms and everything, so you can stream it and everything. But on the 25th is the actual Blu-ray disc, and I'm going to get my Blu-ray. I'm probably going to get both. That's usually what I do, because once one movie get released, I want to see it right then and everything. So I usually just do the get the streaming and then double back and get it. That's how Lucasfilm catch you. But a big thing with the Blu-ray disc is all the collectibles that you can get from the different retailers. I'm not going to buy it from Target, Walmart, and so-and-so. I'll probably get the Target one, because that one did look cool. Shout out to Walmart, though, because that is my employer. So I maybe should be spending my money with my employer. But the Target one looks like it had the most bang for the buck, if you will. And I really was looking forward to it. I don't remember exactly what was in it. I didn't have that written down, but I knew once I was comparing them, looking at both of them, I was like, yeah, Target got my money with this one. So I'm super excited for that. On the 25th, like I said, the Blu-ray will get released. And on the 14th, it'll be released digitally on all current streaming services. We don't know when Disney streaming service coming through, so maybe then. And the last in news, I got a couple book news. Thrawn Alliance is released. I'm like halfway done with that. Like I said, I'm running late on a lot of things, but life is life, and that's what happens. And I will be getting to y'all with my first thoughts and my review of the Thrawn Alliance's book in a maybe in a couple hours. Be on the lookout for it. And like I say, like I was super excited going into the book. I'm not gonna go too deep into it right now, but it is what I thought it was, and so far so good. Yeah, I'll get more on that in next couple hours maybe. I just gotta see. But another book that got announced, I think it was at Comic-Con, that Claudia Gray, one of the best Star Wars writers right now, is doing a Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan story. And that was super exciting to me because I never was like crazy. I never wanted to know most stuff about Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan, more so Qui-Gon and his connection to the underworld and everything that he knew about from what I hear, and how he knew Cypher Diz, Dooku trained him and all that. Maybe they go more deep into that. We get more on Cypher Diz and stuff like that. Get to solve that mystery finally, because that's a mystery we got teased with throughout in episode 2. They touched on it a little bit in the original Clone Wars. But maybe we can go a little deeper into that, and I am super excited for this book. Claudia Gray is what I think 3 for 3 with Star Wars books at this point. All her books have been masterpieces, so I'm crazy excited. Not necessarily when I heard a Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan story, but Claudia Gray, I'm in. So I haven't got a release date for that one yet, but when more is revealed, you can catch me right here at the Uneducated Network. And that is all for the news so far. Well, like I say, it was a couple more news things, like casting for episode 9, that maybe I'll speculate in a later time, but it's not something I really wanted to talk about right now. But that, like I said, that's it. That's it for today. You can keep it locked right here at the Uneducated Network at Uneducated Star Wars Talk. Be on the lookout for my new movie show, The Movie Maniac. I teased it a couple of, I think it was like last week, but I am putting that in the works, and that should be coming to y'all real soon. 'Cause I love talking about movies and everything, so what other platform, what better way to do it than just do it on the platform I got right now. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to share the video, leave a thumbs up, like us on Facebook at the Uneducated Network. You can follow me on Facebook, Chris Lamb, but Twitter, Bubba Kush 92, also Instagram, Bubba Kush 92, and all that good stuff. But until next time, keep it locked right here. Bye-bye.